Hello, I'm working from home today in my sweatshirt. I threw on my pearls for you and just want to talk to you a little bit about searching for homes and showing homes. So one of the things that we're hearing right now is just this madness about, you know, 30 people lined up to see a home, 10-minute opportunity to look at a home, and then they want to have you offer $50,000 over with an appraisal gap and all of this madness. And I feel like I have a responsibility to talk to you about the best way to go about this. First of all, I think it should be a very data-driven and knowledge-driven process. And what we are seeing is people are falling out of contract because they're making very emotional decisions, getting caught up in bidding wars and all of that kind of thing. And I just would like to keep my clients away from things that are not in their best interest. So I want to talk to you about a little bit of the process. First of all, hopefully I'm part of the process of you searching for a home. So that means you have either my KW app or my RE Colorado app. I've set up a search for you. Even if it's for 5 years down the road and you're not ready right now, we're educating ourselves about the market. We're finding the best place. We are eyes on, just trying to figure out what's really out there so that you make the best decision. So there's no rush with me. I don't care. It took me 4 years to find my house. And when I found it, I was ready to go. And I just feel like finding the right home, it also includes the right timing, and I'm on your timing. But I want to be a part of that search for you. Every morning I get up and I do search for people that are probably years down the road, but we are educating ourselves right now on what's happening in the market, and we'll know when there's a deal or when, you know, it's a great piece of property, things like that. So once you've found something that you want to look at, let's say we have that search set up, and I can send you the link if you would like for my app. Once that we found a property that you want to look at, then first thing I want to do is you and I both, we're going to look at Google Earth, and we're going to look and see, like, are there parks around the property? Is there walkability features? Are there restaurants that you can go to? What is happening around the house that might be desirable, but also what might be undesirable? Is there, you know, are there houses around it that have had deferred maintenance? Is there some kind of noise pollution around? Is there, you know, power lines? Is there a railroad track or something like that? Or do the neighbors have things that are not going on or that are going on that aren't so good? So we're going to look at that first. Then we're going to go to Google Maps and we're going to look at the street view and get an idea of what's happening on the street. They only update every 2 to 3 years in the suburbs and pretty much in the city. And so it's not going to be a perfectly accurate look at the street, but it could give you an idea of the vibe of the neighborhood. And then the next thing I would say is check out the schools. While I think this is something that there needs to be a little education on, while I can't, you know, tell you what schools are good and what schools aren't good, I can certainly point you in the direction of schools that would, you know, maybe meet your needs. So I can give you a website, and one that I like to use is actually www.greatschools.org, and it can give you some scores on schools and how they perform. I don't know the specific performance of each school in, you know, all the areas that I work in, and it's a moving target. So it would be really presumptuous of me to say, yeah, this is a great area. Yes, there are schools that have better reputations than others, but I don't know exactly what it is that's best for you. And so to think that I do would be a misjudgment. So I would just point you there, look at the schools, see if the schools are good, and then go drive the neighborhood. Hopefully your realtor, me, is also going to be able to preview the property. Now, right now, it's very hard for me to get in and preview properties. They're extremely tight with showings. And so I'm going to go drive the neighborhood. I'm going to take my camera. You and I are going to be on FaceTime. And we're going to be looking at the property and making sure that the neighborhood has a good feel, that the house looks like it's good in good maintenance, if that's what you're looking for. And then after we've sort of done that work, then I am going to provide you with comps for the property, okay? So we need to know before we go in, what are properties like this selling for in the neighborhood? And what have they been selling for in not the last year, but in the last 90 days as we've seen the market change so much and just prices really escalate? We want to make sure that we're not at the absolute top and then offering beyond that. We want to know what the real hard data is showing on the price of the house and not get caught up in the frenzy, if you will, of the market right now, and just stay data driven and knowledge based. And then the last thing is that I think is something of value that I do is I'm in communication with the realtor on the listing side, on the buy side. I'm communicating to create a really positive relationship so that when we make an offer, if we make an offer, I've already got a relationship. They're watching for my contract to come through. They know I'll be good to work with. They know that I am going to bring a solid client to the transaction. So these are some things I think might be helpful to you. And if you would like me to set up a search for any area, I'd be more than happy to do that. And if you want to just talk about real estate at any point in time, I'm more than happy to do that for you. Remember that when you refer me, it's incredibly helpful to my business. And frankly, that's how I find most of my clients is through referrals. So have a great day. Hope that was helpful. Take care. Be safe out there.